In today's video, let's review new, promising AI 3D model generation Sparc3D that produces 3D meshes with amazing amount of details. Let's check it out. Hey guys, this is Stefan and today we're taking a look on Sparc3D, which is an amazing new tool that you can test for free and that actually creates something insane in terms of details. We will be comparing it with Hunyan 2.5, and if you remember my last video, I was comparing multiple models that create 3D models and Hunyan 2.5 providing more detailed 3D meshes. So this one is actually about it and we will compare it with it. So here is the website, you can take a look and you can go and check demo. It's actually the place where you create the models, so basically it's very easy. You attach an image, you wait some time and it gives you some results. If it's a crowded day, then it might take a while to do your generation, but within 3 to 4 minutes you can have your model. So guys, the important thing to know about this that currently they do not create textures. They only focus on meshes and the meshes incredibly nicely detailed. But in the end of the video, I will show you how you can take this model and actually texture it with another AI. However, we will compare it with Hunyan 2.5, which can do textures as well, which is obviously an advantage, and we'll see like if it's worth it or not to actually use sometimes a Sparc3D, or is it even better than Hunyan 2.5. So I created a few images in steampunk style with simple level of details, then more details and more details. So there will be 3 tests. So first one, let's start with this cute little dog in steampunk clothes. So I already did a test and here is our models. So the right one is from Sparc3D and the left one is from Hunyan 2.5. As I said, the first one at the Hunyan model also goes with texture, while this one, the Spark, doesn't goes with texture right away. But let's see the details. And their biggest claim is that they actually have a lot of details in geometry. So let's take a look. Right away, on a closer look, we can see that it is noticeable. So, well, look at the fur. Look how many stripes and how accurate and detailed they are, right? And the front back, this is very accurate. And what I can tell, both resulted in a very good models, that's for sure, and Hunyan 2.5 is still amazing. But there is less details, noticeably, right? So we can take a look here, we can compare forehead, like mouth, cheeks, all the things. Eyes and gears look pretty much the same in terms of details, while I can see those small things are more outlined, I think, here, right? But, and from the back, yeah, just like maybe less details, but I mean, more or less similar. And to be honest, maybe I like the back of the head more in Hunyan 2.5, but this one is also good, quite good result. So let's say if we have this task in mind, well, probably at this level, I will choose Hunyan 2.5 because it also goes with texture out of the box, right? And the texture is quite nice. Yes, it is sometimes blurry, it's sometimes less details, but again, guys, this is amazing. Like just from the single photo, we can have this result. All right, let's move on to more complex detailed example. Okay, so here's my next image. I used to create a female knight in a steampunk style. All right, so let's review the results. So as usual, right side Sparc3D and left side Hunyan. Well, the difference now is more prominent. The first thing that brought my attention is face, and we can see how significantly more blurry it is in Hunyan. Right, and there were way more details in Sparc3D, like we can see the eyes, etc., the mouth, the nose, and the gears as well. Like they are more sophisticated, like the details more sophisticated, And I don't really understand, like, this stone scars here. I think that they're more logical here. But overall, all the rest of the details, even to look at the glows here. I mean, they're so detailed. I mean, this is amazing. And here we can see it's just a hand, and to be honest, not the nicest hand I ever saw. It's well known issues like the hands for AI models, not always the easiest thing. Probably here there's also an artifact, like three finger only. Oh, strange. But yeah, look at the difference in terms of details. So if you go for 3D printing, I mean, this is absolutely the best model for 3D printing, as per my opinion. Yes, again, the 3D model from Hunyuan goes with textures, but I don't really like how it actually creates faces. And the more details we'll bring up, even though the details themselves are there, together with texture, they're not always perfect, and there might be a lot of things missing or annoying. So from this point, I think you might consider which one works the best for you right now. And for 3D printing, obviously, I would choose like this one, because the model comes really, really nicely detailed. But having a texture is a good advantage. And now let's move on to the third one, the whole miniature city that we will try to create. Should be a lot of details. Let's see how it works. Okay, so I guess this could be called as ultimate test for details. So on this level, the differences are very prominent. So we can see that in general, all the shapes here are smooth, are a bit blurry in some sort, but still Hunyuan gives us very, very good level of details. But Sparc3D is just on another level. Look, I mean, these things, all the shapes, all the things are really sharp, and like we can see, like all things, like all shapes, even inside, like all these small streets. Look, I mean, this is amazing. Like, and again, guys, that this is created from a single image. Right from the back, we also see all the details here. They are very logical. I mean, these pipes, all the things. Wow, this is really nice. On a Hunyuan model, we can see the backside is, probably this is sort of pipes, but they are not that good from the back. You see like merging in one into another and so on and so on. But yet, if we take a look in textures, this is less noticeable. I think probably the only thing is that, yeah, I mean, the backside is doesn't make too much sense, and you can compare like the backside here is, I mean, it's more, much more logical, I think, in some way. So wow. And in terms of composition, this one looks much more accurate. So this is definitely really nice detailed 3D model which follows the prompts very good. So this is really a good model, but we need to understand the pros and cons, right? So one of the noticeable thing is the size. So all that details are achieved because we have a lot of polygons. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. And this model alone will take 2 million polygons. And in average, as I tested, like all the models are pretty much the same 2 million. While Hunyuan model usually takes no more than 500,000. So the size for Hunyuan models can go from 50k to 500k, which is significantly less. And it goes with texture. But for purposes like 3D printing, this is absolutely a must try thing. And again, guys, this is absolutely free right now. I hope soon enough it should be open to test locally and we can play around with it more. But right now you just can go on Hugging Face and take a look. As promised, I can also show you how you can texture the model without texture with another AI. So for this example, we will need to do one thing. So we will take a dog model that we created in Spark, and we will throw it to Blender. So the thing is that it's extremely high poly, and first thing we need to do is optimize it. Luckily, there is a lot of tools to do that in few clicks. So what we're gonna do, we'll select the model, we go to modifiers, and we add, find a decimate. So here in decimate, we can see that currently it's still almost 2 million, which is not really good. And our goal is to reduce it to around 500,000 or less. But before we do that, we need to press on the model, press Shift, press M on the keyboard, and select by distance. This will help us to merge some spare vertices that are not connected. And when you see this window here, we need to change the value to 001 and press Enter. Now what we will see is that there are 71,000 vertices removed, which is good. Now we press Tab, and we see that model barely changed, and we already have the face count reduced. So that's important step. The next one is very easy. What we're gonna do, enter the value 0.25, press Enter, wait a little bit, and after 10 seconds it will give us the model with the face count less than 500,000. That's fine. What we're gonna do is press this arrow, apply, and do the very last thing before exporting. We select the model, press Tab, press A on the keyboard, go to the UV tab, unwrap Smart UV project. So basically we are unwrapping the model with automatic approach so we can actually apply the texture. Okay, we press unwrap, all good. Now we can press Tab again to return, and we're ready with all the procedures. This is our optimized mesh. So now we just need to go File, Export GLTF GLB, select the folder where we want to export it, and press Export. But before pressing Export, you need to go to Data, Mesh, and uncheck the Normals. So because it will affect the size significantly, and we need to feed some specific values. And you can press Export. Now, when you have optimized 3D model, we can go to hyper3d.ai, go to OmniCraft. Here, there are amazing tools for those who use AI tools to create 3D models. So here, there are texture generation. You can also try mesh editor. You can try HDRI generator, and you can convert different formats. It's absolutely for free, but you need to be subscribed to any package. So how it works, very simple. Let's first add our model that we just optimized. So here it is. And let's add it to the image that we used to generate this model. And press generate. And after a while, we have the result. So it looks good. I think Hunyuan might still deliver better results. But again, taking into account that here you can texture pretty much any model, and this model might be used for different purposes with these details. So guys, this tool is up to you to use. As usual, thanks a lot for watching, subscribe to not miss more videos, and guys, see you in the next video.